following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Tell me which one came first and which one came after. Hey, hi, how are you? You're in time for this. Come on, come on, come on in. Watch this. Marlon, slide over. Because this is a rough game. You're going to have to...
Hi, Marlon.
Hi, Susan.
Hi,
where are you going?
What you doing?
Well, I got pictures of you.
Pictures of me?
Oh, yeah. Do I have pictures of you?
Where'd you get those pictures of me?
You weren't watching. Somebody snuck in and took them.
Now, I remember.
You remember?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Four pictures, and here's what Marlon's going to have to do. Marlon's going to have to tell us which one of these four pictures came first. Now, that's the first trick, Marlon, so figure out what's the first thing. Let me point him out. Here's Susan. She's setting the table, right? Here, Susan and I are eating. The next one, Susan is washing the dishes. And over here, Susan is serving me. Now, what happened first?
Well, that one came first, then came this one.
Well, slow down. Wow, which one? This one? That's first.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, because you said that she's setting up the table.
Okay, that's first. Now, which one's second?
This one.
Where she's serving me?
Yeah.
Okay, tell you what then, let's put this one over in here. Okay? Now we've got one and we've got two. Susan sets up the table, then she serves me. Now what's next?
This one.
Down here?
Yeah.
Where we're eating. That's the third one. Marlon, you're pretty good at this. So we only have one more, and that's the fourth one. Now let's go over it again. First, Susan sets the table, right?
Yeah.
Second, she serves me breakfast. I guess it's breakfast, right?
No, that was lunch.
That was lunch, okay. She serves me lunch. Then third, we're eating the lunch. And then fourth, she has to do what?
Wash the dishes,
as always.
And you notice I'm not there?
Yeah, you see? She's by herself, too, isn't she? Listen, I have to go. I'm going to catch a sail downtown.
Okay.
Bye, Marla.
Right. That was good.
Hey, Bert. Come in here for a second.
What do you want?
Come in here if you really want to see something terrific. Come on in, Bert.
Okay, what is it?
Well, let me show you. See, right down here, I got a hoop. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
And grab the hoop.
Okay, I got
hold
it.
Up, hold up that hoop and you'll see something terrific.
Hold up the hoop.
Hold
okay,
up
like
the hoop.
That? Yeah?
No, no, no. Hold it up sideways, Bert.
Oh, sideways, like
yeah,
that.
Right, that's right. Okay.
I don't see anything terrific.
Well, you will. Just a second.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, Snooky. Come in, Snooky. That's Snooky. He's a little friend of mine.
He's a little friend of yours. He doesn't look too friendly. Yeah, he doesn't look too little either.
Oh, he's okay, Bert. He's okay. I found him out on the on the street, and I brought him in, and I trained him, and I trained him how to jump through the hoop.
Through the hoop.
Yeah. Now, if you just hold up the hoop, okay?
Oh.
Snooky, now listen. Uh-huh. When I call you, I want you to come running to me, jump through the hoop, and come to me, and I will give you a cookie.
Cookie?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Ernie,
okay,
Ernie,
okay.
Ernie.
What?
I don't want to do this. Really don't.
Oh, it's okay, Bert. Just hold up the hoop.
Okay? All right.
Just hold up the hoop. Okay, Snooky, come on. Come to Papa. Come on, Snooky. Come on.
Cookie?
You didn't do it right.
Mm-hmm. I'll say.
No, no, no. See, you went over the hoop.
You went over me, too, Ernie.
Yeah, and see, you see, Snooky, what you're supposed to do is go through the hoop. So next time, go through the hoop. Don't go over the hoop. Now go back there and we'll try it again. Okay? Go on back. Go on back. Good boy.
Ernie.
Good boy.
Ernie.
What?
No. No. I don't like this hoop-holding job at all. Look, I got a great idea, okay? Why don't you hold the hoop and I'll stand on the other side and let him come to me, okay? Yeah?
No. Can't do that, Bert.
No?
No. See, I'm his master and he has to come to me. Okay?
Okay.
Hold up the hoop.
Oh, I don't like this.
Just hold up the hoop, Bert.
Really?
Yeah, just hold up the hoop.
Oh, boy.
Okay, Snooky. Ready, Snooky? Okay, Snooky, come to Papa. Come on, through the hoop.
Wait! I don't want to tromp on me again, Ernie.
No. Snooky, don't go over the hoop, remember? Okay, hold up the hoop, Bert. Go ahead.
Cookie.
No. You did it wrong again. That time you went around the hoop. Now, you're supposed to go through the hoop. Okay, now go on back. Go on back, fella. We'll do it one more time. Go on back. That's right. Go on. Okay.
Ernie, I don't want to do it. No.
No. Just hold up the hoop, Bert.
Okay, this is the
one
last
more
time. Last time, though.
This is the last time.
Promise?
Hold up the hoop.
Okay.
Okay, Snooky, baby. Okay, Snooky, come on.
Yeah.
Through the hoop.
Yeah.
Through the hoop, Snooky. Come on. Come on. Wow. Oh, it's beautiful.
Hey, he did it.
Very good.
He did.
Way
do
to
it.
Go, Snooky. Good boy.
Yeah, cookie.
Okay, well, don't worry. Don't be so anxious for your cookie.
Give me a cookie.
I mean, you'll get your cookie. I mean, I don't have one with me right at
no.
the moment. Well, no, because the cookies are in the kitchen, you see.
Kitchen?
And, yeah.
Oh, Ernie. Not only did he jump through the hoop, he jumped through our kitchen door.
Norma, you know what that is? That bird.
A goose.
That's a goose. That's absolutely right. It's a goose. One of Big Bird's distant cousins. It's called a pilgrim goose. Hey, pilgrim goose? Pilgrim goose? I don't really think he wants to pay too much attention to us. He just wants to walk around. Throw him some pilgrim goose food. Looks like corn. You notice he has webbed feet?
Mm-hmm.
Why are his feet webbed? You tell me, Norma. What do you think?
He walks with them.
He walks with them, right. But they help him out when he's in water. Ducks have webbed feet, swans have webbed feet, and geese have webbed feet. You know, when you have more than one goose, you don't call them gooses. You call them geese. Long neck. He is the quietest goose I've ever seen. You ever see a goose that quiet, Norma? Well, when he does make a noise, it's like a honk, honk, honk. He honks.
You know, this is an A. A is my favorite letter in the whole alphabet. You know, A is the first letter in the alphabet, too. But that's not why it's my favorite letter. A is the first letter in the word apple. See, there it's apple. But that's not why it's my favorite letter. A is also the first letter in the word ant. See, there's the word ant. But that's not why it's my favorite letter. The reason that A is my favorite letter is because it's the first letter in a word that describes my girlfriend. Adorable. Adorable, and that's what she is. Come on in, honey.
Hi.
This is Adrian.
Hi.
And isn't she adorable? I'll tell the world. Yeah.
Oh, Jeff.
A, you're adorable. B, you're so beautiful. C, you're a cutie full of charm.
Oh.
D, you're my darling. And E, you're exciting. And F, you're a feather in my arms.
A feather? That tickles.
G, you look good to me. H, you're so heavenly. I, you're the one I idolize. J, we're like Jack and Jill. And K, you're so kissable. And L is the love light in your eyes. M, N, O, P, I could go on all day. Q, R, S, T, alphabetically speaking, you're okay. You made my life complete. V means you're very sweet. W, X, Y, Z. It's fun to wander through the alphabet with you to tell you what you mean to me. You're really a cute sweetheart, you know that.
Oh, thanks, Jeff.
Mm-hmm.
I like you.
Oh, I really like you, too.
Hey! Where's my blocks?
Gee, I didn't know those were your blocks.
Yeah.
Well. A.
Yeah.
B. There's B. C. Let's see. Here we have D. And E. And F.
F.
Yes, right. G. And then H.
Where's my I?
There's I. Here's I. J. And then K.
I'm not K.
And L. Right. And M is right down here.
M. Who's the rest?
M. N. And O. P. I could go on all day. Of course.
Go ahead.
Yes. Well, here we have Q.
Yeah.
R.
Yeah.
And S. T. Alphabetically speaking, you're okay, fella. U. And V.
Hurry.
W. X, Y, Z. It's been fun to wander through the alphabet with you to tell you what you mean to me.
Boy, it sure was a good soda, Mr. Cooper.
Cooper? I'm glad you liked it.
It was wonderful. How much do I owe you?
10 cents.
10 cents?
Yes, 10 pennies.
10 pennies? I don't have that much. All I have is this little bitty dime.
Oh,
just one tiny dime.
That's all right, Big Bird. One dime is worth the same as 10 pennies.
It is?
Sure.
You sure?
Let me show you. One, two, three, four, five.
That's
six,
five.
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Ten.
10 pennies is worth the same as a dime.
They are?
Yes.
Well, I didn't know that. Boy, but that is an awfully large number, 10. I don't know if I can learn that.
Oh, that's very easy.
It is?
Yes. How many fingers have I?
Well, I'm not sure.
One, two, three, four,
five,
six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Why, you have 10 pennies on your hand.
Right.
No, those are fingers.
And on the table.
10 fingers on the table and ten pennies on your hand. Can I do that? Can I count your fingers?
Please.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Okay, first of all, what part of the face is this?
Eye.
An eye. Let's see. Now, you're going to tell me if I put it in the right place.
No.
No?
No.
Oh, it'd make a nice decoration for his hat. That's not where eyes go, though.
No.
What about that? What about that?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll put that right there. Now, what part of his face is this?
Nose.
The nose.
How are you gonna breathe?
Through his ear? Does he breathe? He breathes through his necktie. Oh, that would look cute on his tie.
Yeah.
He breathes through his hat?
No.
Up here on his tie?
No.
Where should it go around?
There.
Yes. Hey, that's a great nose. That's a pretty color. Wow, what is this?
A mouse?
A frankfurter?
No.
Half of a cantaloupe?
No.
Where's this go? What is it?
Mouth.
The mouth.
Where's that go?
No.
Yay! Right there. Now he's in pretty good shape now, except he's missing something.
One of his eyes.
Should we make a set out of him?
Yeah.
Okay, let's not make him too cross-eyed. Well, let's make his eyes a little closer together. Okay. Uh-oh. This eye's on here for good. Well, he's just gonna have to look like this. This eye should be a little here.
This one's up.
Yeah, that one's up a little higher, but he's all right. Do you know how funny you'd look if you lost your nose?
No.
Well, look. Doesn't he look funny?
Now, guys, I've got a couple of very simple questions to ask you about some of the people that live around our neighborhood.
Mm.
Okay, you ready?
No,
not really. Are you ready?
Get ready now, because here's the first one. Okay. Who delivers the milk in our neighborhood?
You know that?
The cow?
No. The cow gives the milk, but he doesn't deliver it.
The farmer?
No. The farmer milks the cow, but he doesn't deliver it.
The cow?
How about the paper boy?
Not the paper boy.
No, he didn't do it.
You give up?
Did you say cow?
He said cow already.
We give up.
The milkman.
That's an easy one. That's an easy one.
You want a hard one now?
I knew that one all along.
Why did you just say it?
You were just saving the answer. Okay, here's another one. Yeah. Now, who picks up the trash in your neighborhood?
Oscar.
No, not Oscar.
Oscar didn't pick it up?
No.
The milkman.
No.
Well, it worked once.
I pick it up sometimes.
That's good.
When I drop it, you know. I always pick it up.
Sure, keep streets clean that way.
Right. I'm not a litter bug.
No.
That's a good idea.
Yes,
you give up? Who picks up the trash?
Litter bugs.
No. The trash collector or the sanitation man.
I knew that.
Why didn't you say that?
Listen, I think you guys need a little help with, you know, the people that work around your neighborhood. Right? What they do. Now, I'm going to sing you a little song and tell you about some of the people around our neighborhood, okay?
Do we have a choice?
No, you really don't.
Go ahead and sing.
Now, listen carefully. Now, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? Say, who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day. Now, for instance, if I put this little bag over your shoulder like this, right?
Oh, I know who
and
that's
put a cap on your head, you know who you'll be? The postman.
Oh, the postman always brings the mail. Through rain and snow and sleet and hail. I'll work and work the whole day through to get your letter safe to you.
'Cause a postman is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
The postman is a person in your neighborhood.
He's
a person that you meet each day.
Hey, and you know who you could be? If I put this hat on you, you'd be the fireman in our neighborhood.
A fireman is brave, it's said. His engine is a shiny red. If there's a fire anywhere about, well, I'll be sure to put it out.
'Cause a fireman is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
And a postman is a person in your neighborhood.
Well, they're the people that you meet
when you're walking down the street. They're the people that you meet each day.
Hey, Ronald. You ever been to the circus?
No.
Never? How about you, Marlon?
No.
Never saw a circus. Circus is a lot of fun. It's got a lot of animals around, clowns.
Elephants.
You're absolutely right. You want to hear a story about some elephants?
Yeah.
You do?
A clown.
Okay, it's a story called Circus Baby. Once there was a mother elephant who lived with a circus. Her baby marched beside her in every parade. Now, sometimes when the sun was very, very hot, the tired little elephant would stop short. He would not take another step. For Mother Elephant, this was most embarrassing. She had to pick him up with her long trunk and carry him. But all in all, Mother Elephant was very proud of her baby. A Mother Elephant was friendly with all the people in the circus. Best of all, she loved Zombie the Clown and his family. She spent much of the time with her head poked through the flap of Zombie's tent. Her tiny black eyes saw everything. Her ears were so big, she could hear everything. She liked to watch the clowns when they were eating. Mr. Clown sat at one end of the table, with Mrs. Clown at the other end. The baby clown, with a pretty bib tied around his neck, sat in a high chair in the middle. The mother elephant decided that her baby must learn to eat properly, just as the circus people did. One day, when Mr. and Mrs. Clown were still in the big circus tent, Mother Elephant awakened her child. "Shush," she said to the sleepy baby. "Come with me, but don't make any noise." The little elephant took hold of his mother's tail. Stepping softly, they made their way across the circus grounds. They tiptoed right up to the clown's empty tent. After Mother Elephant and her baby were both inside the tent, she was surprised at how little space there was. But she was very careful not to break anything. She held her big flappy ears close to her head, and she made herself just as small as possible. She sat her baby up on Mr. Clown's stool. The baby clown's high chair was much too small. She tied Mrs. Clown's apron around his neck for a bib. In front of him, she placed a bowl of beans and the largest spoon she could find. Now, the little elephant always tried to do what his mother wanted, but he just could not manage that spoon. He tried with one foot and then with another. His trunk was always in the way. At last, he held the spoon with his trunk. The beans spilled all over the apron bib and all over Mrs. Clown's nice, clean tablecloth. Mother Elephant coaxed him to try once more. He put his foot out to hold the bowl. The bowl tipped and clattered off the table. Then Mr. Clown's stool gave a loud creak and split into many pieces. The baby elephant went tumbling to the floor. Just at that moment, they heard Mr. and Mrs. Clown coming home. Poor Mother Elephant. She was so excited, she reared straight up. The tent collapsed right over her head and right over the little elephant. Then the surprised Mr. and Mrs. Clown saw their tent walk away. The next day, Mr. and Mrs. Clown were given a beautiful new tent. Mother Elephant promised never to go into it. And she said to her baby, "My child, you do not have to learn to eat as the circus people do because, after all, you are an elephant." Now, how'd you like that?
Yeah.
That was okay? Told the elephant to do his own thing. He didn't have to eat like the circus people. Too small, huh? Eat with his trunk. Oh, okay.
Did he make a mess?
He made a mess. Oh, yeah, he made a big mess. This is a good book, right? Mm-hmm. What kind of shape is this book?
Rectangle.
Rectangle. Hey, Ronald, that was terrific. It is a rectangle. You knew it too, didn't you, Marla?
Yeah.
Okay, it's a rectangle. Why? Because it has how many sides?
Four. four.
Four sides. Now, you guys are so smart, I really don't have to tell you this. How many corners does it have?
Four.
Right? You go along with that? Sure, four corners? Okay. This is a rectangle, that's right. There are rectangles, you know, almost every place you look.
Oh, boy, looks like I'm not tall enough to reach this comfortably. Well, have to get a box. This box. Notice this box, this side, huh? It's a rectangle. Now, I put the box down, and I step on it, and I reach the aeroplane. Eh? That was simple, as easy as pie, when you use a box to help yourself.
Are you sure about what this is?
Yeah.
Baby beef food and milk?
Yeah. Let's give him some too.
That poodle loves it.
He was putting his paws into it.
It's a baby poodle. Come on, don't eat it all. Don't let him eat it all.
He should lick his fingers.
Well, wait a minute. Before we go down there, let's let yours, Ariana.
Like it.
It's
like baby food.
It's milk mixed into it.
That's enough.
Okay. You two. Snap to and eat. It's chow time. Come on. What about my man down here? Taking a nap?
Yeah, he's sleeping.
Ah, there it
is. You got him dirty. Got me dirty. Got me dirty. Come on, stop it. No more food until later.
You know the name poodle really comes from Germany. Do you know poodles came from Germany?
No.
The word poodle means splash in water.
Why'd they call him poodle? They don't splash in water.
That sounds like the word puddle. Maybe that's where it came from. Comes from. Games comes coons.
Hey, come on now. Come on. They're gonna eat it all. No, they like that.
You know, when you usually see poodles, you see them with their haircut, you know, trimmed like that. What do you think the poodle feels about that? You think he likes it?
Not so much.
What do you think, Norma?
I feel like somebody's taking a part of his body.
Oh, yeah. Well, these poodles, I don't know how they feel about it. Their names are Tina, Trivet, Trinket, and Tar. Four names that begin with the letter T.
T is for toys and tractor, trains, and teacher, and tiger, and turtles with brains.
6 times 7 is 42. Mechanicsburg is a city in Pennsylvania.
T is also for tickle. And table. And tops. And Texas. And teeth. Why, T never stops.
Now where else can you find four poodles and a goose but Sesame Street? We'll see you soon.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A, H, and T, and by the number 10. The Circus Baby was written by Maud and Miska Petersham, published by Macmillan Company, copyright 1950. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.